Today, it's some of the best basketball in the state of Texas for girls basketball. The teams that have won the last four Girls Division Gold One Bracket Championships are squaring off today in the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational. It's the 10-0 North Shore Mustangs against the 11-0 Duncanville Pantherettes. And it's coming up next on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. Over 200 games played and 10 gyms, and it all comes down to a Division I gold bracket championship game for the ladies, the Duncanville Pantherettes against the North Shore Mustangs. And a very pleasant good afternoon. I'm Gerald Sanchez, along with Madison Wagner. And from Phillips Fieldhouse in Pasadena, it's the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational, and a couple of teams that are very good and a lot of pedigree between these two head coaches. Madison, it all starts with championships, and Duncanville's got quite a few over their illustrious history. 7 state championships in the school's history, and they have won 3 out of the last 4 in this tournament. Last year, it was the North Shore Mustangs that won the championship at this tournament.
You talk about Duncanville and its history with the championships, but Duncanville is not only known for its championships, but also the talent that it produces. This year, a very strong team with 3 of its players signed to D1 schools. One in particular, Sierra Johnson, a 6'4 forward who's going to the University of Louisville.
And she's long at 6'4". And what about North Shore and Allison Campbell, their head coach, and Chastity Patterson?
We had a great conversation with Coach Campbell today about her. She knows how to run the floor. She's a leader. And the Coach Campbell talked about, you know, this is a point guard who's hungry, who's ready to play, and who's ready to score the points and lead her team.
And we are all ready to go as the teams are going to be announced here along with the national anthem. We'll step aside and come back with the starters and the tip-off here from the 2015 Texas Invitational from Phillips Fieldhouse in Pasadena.
The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization working with the community to provide the resources educators and students need to achieve educational excellence. The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation, bringing dreams to life for educators and students.
Have you recently lost your job or been denied medical care? Has your doctor told you their panel is full and they cannot take you? At Pasadena Health Center, we make healthcare affordable and provide access to reliable, quality healthcare in a caring atmosphere. We offer services in family medicine, dental, OBGYN, pediatrics, x-ray, lab, and pharmacy. We accept Medicare, Medicaid, private insurance, and offer discounted fees for self-pay patients. Pasadena Health Center, where caring is what we do best.
Dealership that works hard for us.
You know it.
We deserve low prices and to be told done deal.
At LaPorte Mitsubishi, you know it. We get your deals done with our exclusive guest financing program and the lowest prices like
Outlanders just $209. Outlander Sports as low as $179. Get 2 Mirages for just $299 a month.
Come to LaPorte Mitsubishi and ask for our exclusive guest financing program.
Get your deal done. You know it.
It's the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational, sponsored by the Pasadena Chamber of Commerce, as it is Duncanville and the North Shore Mustangs, the Division I Gold Bracket Championship game. And they are announcing the starting lineups. And so let's look at those starting lineups as we have them. First for the Duncanville Pantherettes, We have Green, Davis, Johnson, and Tally. And some height there, Madison.
Yes, definite height. That's going to help against the 6'4 of Sierra Johnson. And, you know, it's just going to be a great matchup.
For the North Shore Mustangs, Courtney Johnson, along with Okeny, Patterson, Francis, and Victoria Blankenship. And Victoria Blankenship is a move-in over on the east side of Houston. She comes from Corpus Christi and played her high school ball her first 3 years at West Oso. See Duncanville, the Pantherettes. Duncanville has a record of 11-0, and North Shore has a record of 10-0. As we see Courtney Johnson there getting introduced. And let's look at the games that were played earlier between these two ball clubs. For Duncanville, they beat Manville, who Duncanville and Manville played a couple of years ago in the state championship basketball tournament. It stopped Duncanville's 105-game winning streak, Manville going on for the victory. Then they beat Mansfield Summit, which is a local team for them. Cy Fair, they defeated them 66-48. Duncanville and Seven Lakes played earlier this morning in Duncanville all over the Seven Lakes Lady Ball Club. North Shore, their road to the finals. Cy Falls, that was a close game, 42-33. Then they beat Mansfield Lake Ridge, 50-31. Defeated Clear Springs, Pam Crawford's ball club, who a couple of years ago played against Duncanville in this girls' basketball tournament. And then earlier this morning, North Shore defeated San Antonio Brennan in overtime over at Deer Park Auxiliary Gym, 49-40. So we're all ready to go as both teams have been introduced. Also, for the Duncanville Pantherettes, they are in the red. North Shore is in the white. Vincent Feliciano, Larry Johnson, who's about to tip it up, and Jimmy Baldwin are our officials. Ball is tipped, and it is won, and North Shore's got the basketball first, and boy, they don't waste any time taking a three-pointer right there. It is no good. And Duncanville quickly back down the way on the other side, and that is 2 points. And got a whistle. Duncanville's going to be aggressive, Madison.
That's what it's going to take to win this game, with both teams highly successful throughout this tournament. Both teams can soar. You know, we went over those numbers earlier. Duncanville has an average point per game of 70 points. You're going to have to be aggressive tonight to win.
And also turnovers are going to be a key paramount for North Shore. They cannot commit the turnovers because Duncanville will turn those into fast break points quickly. In the corner, Davis. Davis, no good. Rebound comes down to Okeny. North Shore basketball, and we're underway in the first quarter. Francis with the dribble, trying to get away from the five-second call. And that's what we talked about, those turnovers. Okeny just can't handle that pass from Francis, which just very easy, just no one around her, and she just couldn't hold on to it. Pantherettes basketball. Zariel Green's going to handle the ball a lot. Over to Tay Davis. Davis in the lane, too hard off the glass, goes out of bounds. North Shore basketball.
You know, kind of off to a rough start here. We talked about taking advantage of those turnovers, and it looks like Duncanville just can't do it.
Going down the lane, and the shot is there. You can see the physical play. Patterson's going to handle the ball a lot for North Shore. We talked about her in the open. Boy, she is a special talent. Ball knocked out of bounds. She wears jersey number 15. Chastity, it's 5'6". She's a sophomore. And I think
has
she's
more
got,
offers yeah. than we can count, right?
She had more offers than you and I combined. Patterson outside. launches the three-pointer. It's going to be no good. Patterson's going to take a majority of the shots. She took the first shot of the ball game, knocked out of bounds. Still North Shore basketball. Well, she is a special talent. Allison Campbell talked about how she is an extension of herself on the basketball court. Inside, fought for and no good. Victoria Blankenship with that shot, it was no good. Inside Green and count it.
A strong post move there, that's what they're gonna need.
Sierra Johnson getting the post up. Foul is against Blankenship, that is her first, team's first, so she gets an and one opportunity. And she hits it. Hit the back of the iron, just kind of fell in. Duncanville up to a 5-0 lead in this first quarter. Patterson is fouled. Tay Davis didn't think so. The expression on her is like, I fouled her?
I don't think the crowd agreed either. That might have been a tough one.
Davis picks up her second personal foul already. Team foul number two.
How critical do you think fouls are going to be tonight? Limiting and...
Well, Allison Campbell talked about the difference between her ball club and Kathy Self Morgan's ball club is that North Shore doesn't have as much depth as Duncanville. So I would think that the fouls would be more against North Shore. Inside, down low to Green, and Green. Zarell Green, the sophomore, gets the basket, and it's 7-0 already in favor of the Pantherettes. North Shore is going to need a basket on this trip, don't you think?
I agree. You know, you can't get too far with not scoring. They need to switch the momentum here, get some points on the board.
Francis is handling the basketball, not so much Patterson on this possession. Now Patterson outside. Patterson's going to have to play a lot of minutes. Turns the basketball over, and it is stolen by Madison Townley. Davis, Townley going to the basket, gets it blocked. Townley again is called for traveling. 4:52. That was a heck of a block inside as Townley tried to go inside, and it was rejected. 4:52 in the first quarter, Duncanville up by 7. So we have that replay here. Townley was coming down the lane, and it was blocked beautifully. Okuni with the block. So important when you got someone that's really can just shut down inside presence.
It is. I mean, it makes all the difference when you're in there, for sure. You got to keep going, and the stronger you go up, the more of a chance you're going to have of getting that foul called.
As you can see, Duncanville's got a little bit of a height advantage over North Shore. The Mustangs are going to, when those plays happen, really take advantage and spark the other ball club. Chastity Patterson out on the dribble with Ty Davis holding her. And Davis is called for, well, actually, they beg your pardon. They call it a turnover. Good defense by Davis. It's Kathy Self Morgan. Townley with the basketball. Three-pointer Johnson in and out, no good. And it is Patterson the rebound. Patterson can do a lot of dribbling, but against this bigger team like Duncanville, they're going to have to get creative. An offensive foul is called. Victoria Blankenship picks up her second personal foul. Alley-oop inside. No good. Sierra Johnson, and they call a foul underneath. So they're going to keep it right there. Boy, Johnson, when she gets in the post, she just creates space for herself.
I don't think it's fair. I don't think it's fair. Look at that. She's so strong. Maintains her position. Just going to make it.
Davis to inbound. And another whistle is called underneath. Vincent Feliciano says a little bit too much contact. Patterson picks up the foul, and Madison Townley gets the basket. And a steal. Green, two more. That press, that's one of the scouting reports they talked about. Turnover. Green again to the basket, gets it blocked. Okoney, where would they be without Okoney defensively?
I don't know. How many blocks has she had? Three blocks.
Davis again. Townley throws up the shot. Beg your pardon, Davis throws up the shot. Rebounded by Green, in and out. Okoney fighting for the offensive rebound, or effort for the rebound, trying to get in there. Johnson. Boy, Johnson. She could start on most boys' teams. Going to Louisville next year. A little over halfway through this first quarter, North Shore has yet to get a basket.
They seem to be dribbling a little too much and, you know, really depending on their point guard. They gotta spread the floor, pass the ball. I don't know what's going on. What is your opinion of that? They need to get some points on the board.
Ball movement, perimeter movement, but it's hard to move the ball with a bigger team like Duncanville. A three-pointer in and out, off the glass, almost went in for Rosie Davis. I mean, almost. And then a foul is called.
On the floor.
Foul is against Rosie Davis. That is her first personal. Madison Francis. Team foul number three for Duncanville, so there's no chance of points. Three-pointer by Patterson, no good. Tipped, and Francis with the ball in the corner. Over to Patterson. The flip shot, and North Shore gets on the board for the first time in the ball game.
It's about time, you know. Hopefully this will spark some momentum for them and they can get their offense going.
Off the rim, no good by Green, and up and in is Sierra Johnson. Just creating space for herself to get that offensive rebound. Patterson's really having to work hard, and that's going to wear her down as the game goes on.
I agree. She's got to have some help for her teammates, from her teammates, excuse me. They're kind of stagnant here. There's no movement whatsoever.
Patterson from the parking lot, no good. Davis the rebound. Look at how they run the floor. They can't get the basket to go, but active bodies all over the place. Townley inside. Johnson.
Look at that strength.
Two more. Right now, it has been all Duncanville in this first quarter of the ball game. Green off the glass. Two more.
This timeout is going to be critical for North Shore.
Allison Campbell is forced to call timeout with 1:03 left to play in the first quarter. Duncanville all over North Shore, leading by 15. The way that they are getting out and running and getting the fast break points, if you were to look at a shot chart and see where the majority of their points are, Madison, they're coming in the paint.
Yes, they're making it look easy. Duncanville is doing all of, they're technically sound. They're doing everything that a team is supposed to do, making the bunnies, making the passes. And North Shore just, you know, they didn't get off on the right foot, and they've struggled to find their place.
The spacing, you talked about about what North Shore needs to do, and I had mentioned ball movement, but a lot of that has to do with spacing, and when you've got a bigger defensive team that can cover the court, that is more difficult, especially at this level.
Yes, I agree. And then, you know, you talk about the spacing, and it's, you have Chastity running down the middle of the floor with the other four players on the outside of the perimeter, and, you know, without that force inside, you know, Duncanville is really limiting them to a one-way offense shooting, and I don't know if they're going to be able to win the game like that.
Kirsten Hardeman gets it inside, and Patterson, the free throw line jumper, is good. And getting beat down the floor, Davis.
The efficiency that Duncanville has of executing their fast break, it's fun to watch.
Leading scorer Green with 8 points in the ball game, and 2 points there for Davis, Tay Davis Jr., her first two of the day. Nowhere to go, Francis. She's going to have to do something. Throws up the shot, doesn't draw anything, and Green, the baseball pass, Davis, a little bit too long. And Kevin, our cameraman, good job trying to hold on to that ball. They got Greyhounds, and they can just run up and down the floor, and saw Allison Campbell come off the bench and scream, "Someone get back." Patterson to Francis. Got some nice looking shoes. In fact, all the North Shore Mustangs with the green shoes. No good. And that will do the first quarter. All Duncanville. 19-4 over North Shore on the Time Warner Cable Sports Channel.
We welcome you to North Shore Marine. We support a large parts and accessories for Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. And we also have parts for your boat, not only just the motor. So you can come in and get pretty much everything you need and be on your way. So you name it, we got it. We sell Sea Arc aluminum boats. A wide variety we try to keep in stock so we can accommodate just about anybody. We service Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. We have a master technician in our staff, and he's highly accredited. Well, of course, we're a family-oriented business. We try to keep it on that level. We're concerned for the well-being of our customers. Come visit us at North Shore Marine.
Duncanville, 19-4 over North Shore. If there's a silver lining to this for North Shore's big deficit in this first quarter, Madison, it's that they fell in the championship game last year down by double digits to Cy Woods. And Kim Mulkey and that talented bunch that eventually went on to win the state championship, they fell down by quite a bit, but they were able to rally and come back in the second half and win.
Well, I hope they can do that here today. You know, that would be, this is the beginning of the season. It's a learning experience, and, you know, hopefully they can learn from this first quarter and, you know, move on and get something going.
You know, with North Shore, they lost seven key components last year inside. And Johnson, Sierra Johnson with two more. Johnson now with 9 points. But North Shore lost 7 key players, and of course their number one, Patterson, the point guard, she's just a sophomore. Jump shot is good on the right side by Rosie Davis. But they have been able to go 10-0, and they have been playing outstanding basketball. Patterson missing the shot there. Duncanville is 11-0, so. But Allison Campbell has said, we feel that we've played some quality opponents, but we still don't feel like we're even close to getting it right yet. And I thought, after two more from Sierra Johnson, I thought when she told us that, I thought, wow, you're off to 10-0 start.
Yeah, what's not right about that? She did say, however, you know, she respects this Duncanville team and is really excited to play them here today and just learn from them and, you know, take this and run with it, you know, whether they come out on top or whatnot. She was just really looking forward to playing them here today.
And knocked away. Davis, no good. Francis the rebound, and Francis trying to run, trying to get the defense not set for Duncanville, and they're going to call a jump ball. Official Larry Johnson, and the jump ball possession arrow favors North Shore. Now is when the wave begins of they just keep coming at you with Kathy Self Morgan. You see several substitutions into the ballgame.
When we talked to her earlier today, she talked about the depth that her team has, and you know that can take you a long way in a game like this.
Nina Alvarez and Nisha Davis check into the game for Duncanville. Shot turnaround is no good by Blankenship, and then a foul is called underneath. See the foul? Sierra Johnson said, where was the foul?
I know there was some body contact there, but always respect the refs, right?
But you know what? North Shore will take it. That's their first free throw of this ball game. One more for Blankenship. Seems like there's all, whenever a shot goes up for Duncan, there's always someone right there trying to get an offensive rebound.
I think that is just anticipation and knowing in the chemistry of their team. You know, they know what they need to do, they know where they need to be. It's just all about reading the floor.
Sierra Johnson, yet once again, Johnson with 13 points.
Another fast break here.
Nisha Davis can't get it to go. Nisha off her offensive rebound and puts it up and in. Blocked. Boy, Johnson just clogs up the lane. Davis.
One thing about that play, you watch Duncanville, how many times did they dribble the ball? Once? Spanning the whole court? That's impressive.
Alvarez with the basket, Nina Alvarez. Chastity Patterson is fouled. Team foul number 6 on Duncanville in this first half. Foul was on Nisha Davis. Duncanville, after winning 105 games, lost the state championship game in 2014 to the Manville Mavericks. And then last year, they didn't have all the firepower necessary. They were in a rebuilding stage as they had lost a lot of players from the previous championship run. Patterson gets the three-pointer to go. Then they lost to Plano in the second round. Out of bounds. Tasia Foreman, Cressa Davenport, Ariel Atkins, those are names that were just linked to that championship era run for Duncanville, already to their rich tradition history. Offensive foul is called against North Shore. You see Blankenship trying to split the double team and just was unable to do so. It's Blankenship now with her second personal. North Shore with five team fouls. Too tall. Johnson trying to get inside. Zay Green. Over her head. What type of defense is that, Madison?
We got a 2-3 going on.
Out of bounds.
I don't think they have to do much else. You know, you have North Shore, who likes to dribble the ball up front. A 2-3 is solid. They have big people that are clogging up the middle, them being Duncanville. It's a good defense. It's obviously been very successful with, you know, limiting them to 8 points.
Johnson now with 15 as she continues to cook it up. Kind of like James Harden with the chef.
We've talked historically about Duncanville, and not only historically as a team have they been very successful, but talking to Kathy Self-Morgan, she in her own right has had her own success. It's incredible how long she's been with the program and how many state championships she's won.
Shot is good. Jump shot by Courtney Johnson. Johnson with her first points of the ball game. Closing in on halftime as Sierra Johnson can't get that shot to go. And our halftime guest will be Mr. Ben Metter, the tournament chairman. He has been the tournament chairman since 2003, and this year will be his last year as the tournament chair. What a wonderful job Mr. Ben Metter and all the volunteers have done yet once again in this tournament. As the basket goes inside.
You know, very interesting. They changed from a zone to a man. So maybe that's something that North Shore will be able to take advantage of if Duncanville sticks with that man defense.
Well, if Sierra Johnson keeps having shots like that inside the basket, it's going to be a long game for North Shore.
You're right. It won't matter.
17 points now for Sierra Johnson. It will be a Cardinal next year. Louisville. Blocking foul. The one and one situation, because that is now team foul number 8 for Duncanville. Foul is against Star Jacobs. Star Jacobs, who has just entered the ball game. 5'11" sophomore comes out, and coming in is back to Nisha Davis. As Coach Self-Morgan is, she was having a good word there with the official Jimmy Baldwin. Yeah. 35-12 Duncanville. Nina Alvarez going down the lane. Rainbow shot way off.
I think she's a little intimidated there.
And when Green got the basketball, she was out of bounds on the baseline. The athletic ability of Duncanville, the size.
They have it all. They have the quickness. They have the efficiency. Like I said earlier, they do the little things, and those little things add up to the bigger picture.
Blankenship is fouled away from the basket. The foul is called on Townley. Madison Townley with the personal, with her first personal. Team foul number 9 for Duncanville. So North Shore is just one foul away from shooting the double bonus. By the way, they have made some rules changes in college basketball for the women's game. They are now, as the first free throw is good for Blankenship, they're now 4 quarters. College basketball had always been 2 halves, 20-minute halves. Now they're in women's basketball, at least, there is a quarter, 4 quarters. So they play 10-minute 4 quarters.
That gives them, I guess, a little bit more, you know, rest. And
they're also, and the difference with a college game is compared to high school, is there is no more 1-and-1. Because once they go over the 15th foul in the quarters, it's just automatic 2 free throws. Nice give and go from Johnson to Townley. Johnson showing that she can pass inside the post as well.
A lot of dribbling there, but a good basket.
A lot of work. Yes, it went in, but still a lot of work that North Shore is getting. Duncanville not having to work as hard for their baskets. Madison Townley with 2 more. 41-16. Francis throws up the shot. No good. Gets her own rebound.
When the rebound touches the, when the ball touches the floor and there's no rebound, that's never a good sign.
Madison Francis doing a lot of dribbling, trying to see if she can find a crack in the seam. Blankenship, no good on the inbounds play. Taking their time. End of the quarter. Shot by Davis, no good. And it's rebounded by Johnson. Let it fly. And so we're at the half.
You know, that was a little rough to watch. Who would have known it'd be 41-16 Duncanville right now with such high caliber teams. North Shore had a really rough start.
It's halftime here on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel, and Duncanville well in control.
The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization working with the community to provide the resources educators and students need to achieve educational excellence. The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation, bringing dreams to life for educators and students.
Have you recently lost your job or been denied medical care? Has your doctor told you their panel is full and they cannot take you? At Pasadena Health Center, we make healthcare affordable and provide access to reliable, quality healthcare in a caring atmosphere. We offer services in family medicine, dental, OBGYN, pediatrics, X-ray, lab, and pharmacy. We accept Medicare, Medicaid, private insurance, and offer discounted fees for self-pay patients. Pasadena Health Center, where caring is what we do best.
Dealership that works hard for us.
You know it.
We deserve low prices and to be told done deal.
At LaPorte Mitsubishi, you know it. We get your deals done with our exclusive guest financing program and the lowest prices like
Outlanders just $209. Outlander Sports as low as $179. Get two Mirages for just $299 a month.
Come teleport Mitsubishi. And as for our exclusive YES financing program.
Get your deal done. You know it.
The 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational is brought to you by Pasadena Chamber of Commerce, home of the Texas Invitational, the City of Pasadena, Community Bank of Texas, Bank Where You Live, and by McDonald's. I'm loving it. Halftime with Duncanville well in control of this ballgame. Gerald Sanchez along with Madison Wagner on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. And Madison, your thoughts on the first half? All Duncanville.
All Duncanville. They've done things so easily. Like I said, they can run the floor. They pass efficiently. They make the easy layups. It's unfortunate that North Shore has put all of its efforts through Chastity Patterson, and it's just not fair. They can't get things going with just one person on that team.
If you are Allison Campbell, the head coach of the North Shore Mustangs, what do you tell your ball club at the locker room?
You know, they need to work the ball. You have to mimic. I don't want to say you mimic Duncanville, but you see where Duncanville's strengths are. That is passing. You know, that's not dribbling through three different people. It's not. They're working way too hard. Stop working so hard. Be efficient. Have fun. Play the basketball that they know how to play. Being, you know, 10-0, they've obviously done something right this season, and they're just not doing it right now.
It is 41-16 Duncanville at the half from the Texas Invitational. We'll come back and have a guest, a very special guest, Ben Metter, the tournament chairman since 2003, and this will be his last season.
We welcome you to North Shore Marine. We support a large parts and accessories for Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. And we also have parts for your boat, not only just the motor. So you can come in and get pretty much everything you need and be on your way. So you name it, we got it. We sell Sea Arc aluminum boats, a wide variety we try to keep in stock so we can accommodate just about anybody. We service Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. We have a master technician in our staff, and he's highly accredited. Well, of course, we're a family-oriented business. We try to keep it on that level. We're concerned for the well-being of our customers. Come visit us at North Shore Marine.
Duncanville up 41-16 over the North Shore Mustangs at halftime from Phillips Fieldhouse in Pasadena, Texas. It's the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational. Gerald Sanchez back with you at the half, along with the tournament director, the chairman, Mr. Ben Metter. It's good to see you yet once again.
Yeah, good to see you. Thank you for being here again.
And absolutely a wonderful job again with the tournament. Everything is top-notch. Your volunteers and everybody that's involved with this tournament, an outstanding job. It's the best.
Well, thank you very much. We hear that a lot. And, of course, the credit certainly goes to all the volunteers. We have about 400 people that volunteer each year, and certainly to the sponsors who help us financially with a lot of support there. Prior to the tournament, we raised almost $300,000 to put on this tournament. And, you know, we have about 28 teams from out of the area that we provide lodging for them when they come in, and out of the 80 teams that participate.
Right, and it seems like the tournament every year has grown more and more. I know you've got probably a waiting list, right, for the teams that want to get into the tournament.
We definitely do. We've got waiting lists on both the boys and girls side, and it's rather lengthy. And what we look for is great programs, good coaches and good character, a lot of discipline, and they bring their kids in here for a great experience. And so, you know, in the past, many of the state champions have started their season right here at the Texas Invitational.
And I know from doing the girls tournament for many years, and even some of the boys with DeSoto winning, the championships with Duncanville, with Cy Woods, they're always just so such a good level of competition here.
If you make it to the gold division in Division One, those eight teams, boys and on the girls side, then they're very competitive. It's kind of a mini state tournament, really.
Yeah, absolutely. And some of the other teams that you got over on the boys division, I know that locally, Atascocita, that's a good basketball program, a good basketball team. They'll be playing in the boys championship game later tonight.
Right. They're very good. They're very skilled. And, of course, they've got two of their starters, I think, that are on the football team. And I don't know if they've joined them yet or not, but they look very good, as does Lancaster. Lancaster being a 5A team, they're very, very capable of taking the championship, too.
It's halftime here at the McDonald's Texas Invitational of the Girls Division I Gold Bracket with Duncanville all over North Shore, 41-16. Visiting with the tournament chairman, Mr. Ben Metter. And Ben, this is going to be your last year as the tournament director. The decision into that.
Well, it is. You know, when I first took this job, I told them I'd give them 3 years. And after 13 years, I think it's time to pass the baton to somebody else. And we are going to let Dr. Kirk Lewis, who is a retiring superintendent of our school district, take this position. And Kirk's very capable, and he'll probably take it and build on it and improve it. And I look forward to working with him. We're not going to go anywhere, but as far as the responsibilities, we're going to hand it over to him.
Well, I know that this tournament, you have put so much time and energy, and you and Janice, this is just, you're so synonymous with this tournament, and I know that you would not leave it if it wasn't left in good hands.
Well, that's certainly true, and we've got such a great relationship with many of the coaches. And, you know, I'd like to give credit to our own company, too, because a number of our employees work on this thing year-round, and especially Rita Townsend, who's our tournament executive assistant. In fact, Rita's back at the office tonight taking the scores and working with our webmaster who takes care of all that web business.
And that company is Metter Staffing Services.
Right.
Absolutely. Ben, thank you so much. It's been such a pleasure to be working with you over these years with this telecast, and we can't thank you enough.
Well, thank you, Gerald, and always a pleasure to have you here.
It's our pleasure.
Thank you.
That is Ben Metter, the tournament chairman, won last year for the Texas Invitational here in Pasadena. We'll come back with the second half right after this. The Pantherettes over the Lady Mustangs, 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational, the Division I Gold Bracket Championship game. Gerald Sanchez along with Madison Wagner. Thank you for joining us on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. Duncanville with the ball, rather North Shore with the ball. Duncanville in the red. Mustangs are in the white, red lettering. Tipped away. And we heard Madison's comments. Madison talked about what North Shore Mustangs need to do.
Yeah, and I also think they really need to slow the tempo down of Duncanville. Duncanville gets the rebound, and they're on the fast break. And I really think that if North Shore wants to get back into this game, they need to slow it down. And here is a play that exemplifies my last statement.
A foul as Courtney Johnson commits the foul, and this is going to be a two-shot free throw. Just race out, get transition baskets or free throw opportunities. Tay Davis, Jr. Duncanville gets the first points of the second half. Offensive rebounds yet once again. 19 points for Sierra Johnson. Again, a special thank you to Ben Metter, Metter Staffing Services, the tournament chairman, director. This is going to be his last year. And it has been an absolute pleasure working with him these last 13 tournaments. He said, man, we're only going to do it for about 3 years. Turned into 13.
The love of the game, it'll keep you going.
Allison Campbell showing her players, look, move the feet, get into some defensive positions. Inside Blankenship. That's twice that she's tried to split double teams, and both times she's been ineffective.
Can't do it. You just can't do it. They're big, they have their position, and if you've established your position, you're never going to get your foul called.
That one hits nothing but the bottom of the net. Jump shot, gonna be no good. It's good hustle. Get back on defense for North Shore. Patterson. Boy, look at the defender on Patterson. Look how long she is. Madison Townley. Patterson throws up a crazy shot, can't get it to go. Rebound, and it goes in. Okuni. Alyssa Okuni with the basket. Okuni with 4 points in the ball game. And a steal by Patterson. One person to beat. Tries to use the left hand to avoid the shot block and comes up short. Ball is knocked out of bounds. 47-18, Duncanville.
Duncanville's putting the pressure on North Shore starting this third quarter.
Townley to Green, and two more. You see some of the North Shore brass as the shot goes up and in. Okuni, Allison Campbell right there, along with her longtime assistant, Gigi Gaudet. Geesley Price, who is the daughter of longtime head coach and a legend, Hall of Famer, Joe Willie Price. So he's got some pedigree on that North Shore Mustang bench. They know the game of basketball. Gigi Gaudet has been with Coach Campbell for 14 of the 16 years.
That has to say something about the relationship and the style of play there. To get along, to be able to work together that many years, the respect is definitely there.
Shot will roll off, no good. Last year, North Shore made it to the regional semifinals before losing to the eventual state champion, Cy Woods. There will be a timeout. North Shore Mustangs, 6A. So let's, Duncanville up by 29. As we see inside, just the great ball play of Sierra Johnson in the post.
Her strength, her positioning on the floor, the way she moves other players, she's definitely, you know, she's got it. Making those easy buckets. Louisville's got a good thing coming their way, that's for sure.
She also can play defense. Look how long she is getting that shot block. And then passing out of a double team.
She has the knowledge. She has the basketball IQ and knows where her teammates are going to be. That's what it's about.
So far, she has 19 points.
I wonder, it's going to be interesting to compare her offensive and defensive boards also. She's got a have a combined of, what, 15 or 20? She's owned both sides of the floor.
And every time it seems that North Shore has been able to get a defensive rebound, it's a struggle. There's so many offensive rebounds for Duncanville that they have just had to fight for everything that they've got. Now the timeout, North Shore. See what type of play they have developed with Hardiman. Patterson, free throw line jumper. Got it to go. Patterson, when in doubt, right? Chastity.
I have to give credit to this Duncanville team. You can tell that they are of championship quality when they're up by 27 points. They don't give up. They don't fall to the other team's level. You know, that's very common. When you're up by so much, you can sometimes stump to the other team's level and get sloppy, but they're just as sharp now as they have been the entire game.
Tally with the steal, Green with the opportunity to make another basket, and she does. Zay Green. Heard that Coach Ben, tournament director, Chairman Ben Metter, talked about how championship teams, this is where they start. And that's kind of been the logo, the buzz line that this tournament has developed over the years. They have used the road to state start here. Many of the state champions have started their seasons right here. Both the boys and the girls. Ball is to another steal. For over 92 years, the state tournament was in Austin. But then they moved it over to San Antonio last year at the Alamo Dome. And it'll be at the Alamo Dome again this year in 2016 in March. Oh, nice play. Patterson to Okuney.
And that's what I was talking about before. She gets low, maintains, and establishes that positioning. It's just a drop step and a layup. It's as easy as that.
There's Patterson. Loses the basketball.
And you mentioned earlier, excessive may be a little dramatic, but of the excessive dribbling, and you know that's going to happen. If you continue to do that, those picks and those easy, you know, turnovers are going to take place.
The ball movement always makes the defense work harder, and we haven't necessarily seen that with North Shore. The ball movement has been a lot more dribbling. Madison Francis to inbound. Coming in up on the end of the third quarter. And another basket for Zay Green. Boy, she's been really good. 16 points. Zay Green. Jump ball. Possession arrow favors Duncanville. See if Duncanville holds for the final shot. No? Guess not. Well, when you got it that close and that easy, Sierra Johnson is going to put it in. 23 points for Johnson. And Patterson for three, just short. That'll end the third quarter. North Shore only scoring 8 points. And now they trail 59-24 to Duncanville in the championship game, the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel.
The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization working with the community to provide the resources educators and students need to achieve educational excellence. The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation, bringing dreams to life for educators and students.
We deserve a dealership that works hard for us.
You know it.
We deserve low prices and to be told done deal.
At LaPorte Mitsubishi, you know it. We get your deals done with our exclusive guest financing program and the lowest prices like...
Outlanders just $209. Outlander Sports as low as $179. Get two Mirages for just $299 a month.
Come to LaPorte Mitsubishi and ask for our exclusive guest financing program.
Get your deal done. You know it.
2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational is brought to you by Pasadena Health Center. Caring is what we do best. By LaPorte Mitsubishi, your local car dealership in LaPorte. And by Refined Auto Designs, redesigns.biz. Time Warner Cable Sports Channel presentation of the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational, the Division I Gold Bracket, with Duncanville looking to secure their fourth championship in the last 5 years. They have this gold bracket. And last year, they won the silver division. Begin the fourth quarter. Inside, no good.
It was nice to see them run a play. I haven't seen North Shore run a play. I don't think I saw them run a play the whole third quarter. It was one person dribbling down the middle, and it didn't work. It was very inefficient. Here they run a play, they get a foul, and they have another chance to make a basket.
Short on the shot. And a foul underneath. Well, they just make it so difficult with everything inside. As the free throw is good by Okuni. Phillips Fieldhouse, and there is a special game that they play here every year. They've done it the last 3 years as the basket goes in for North Shore. Madison, it's the alumni game, and the rivalry with Pasadena and Deer Park, the local communities in this area, they have alumni from the Pasadena All-Stars and the Deer Park All-Stars, and they play a game here, and it's in between the girls' championship and the boys' championship, and it's been the last 3 years that they've done that.
And I heard you talking about this with someone pregame, and I don't know if they were joking or serious, but the alumni age anywhere from, 20 to 80 years old. Is that right? They have 80-year-olds out here?
Well, I don't know about 80, but yes, it's in their 20s all the way to folks in their 50s and 60s. And those are guys that played against each other back in the day, and it's... Boy, this place gets packed, and there's still a lot of rivalries and bragging rights and so forth between Pasadena and Deer Park. Just imagine if they could throw in some of the LaPorte people in there, too. Boy, that would be really something with Deer Park and LaPorte, their rivalry, too. North Shore to inbound. Madison Francis inbounds it to Chastity Patterson. Patterson has played every minute of this ball game. And it's too long, no good. Rebound comes down to Blakenship, and she is fouled. She'll go to the line.
The forwards of North Shore, the forwards and the center there, have really shown up in this fourth quarter. Trying to fight her way in there for the basket and rebound. It's, you know, that's what you got to do.
So we're not going to take it anymore. It's Blankenship to the line. Blankenship with 7 points, can't connect on her free throw there. Tiara Franklin, we haven't mentioned her tonight, just a brief appearance in the ball game, and Zay Green comes back in for Duncanville. No good on both free throws. That is only the second team foul for Duncanville. North Shore has only had one team foul. They were originally started to start this game at 5:30, or excuse me, at 4:30, and it wasn't until about 5:45 that they started. Local time. That'll still be North Shore basketball. Hats off to Allison Campbell and her squad. They are fighting. They are continuing to fight, even though the score is well in Duncanville's favor by 30 points. Chastity Patterson from downtown with 14 points. She is the leading scorer for the Mustangs, as was to be expected. Offensive foul is called as Blankenship stands in there.
Those are never fun.
No.
Those hurt. It takes a lot of guts to stand up and hold your ground.
Green is saying, me? Three-pointers blocked. Blankenship gets it blocked. Boy, that is, by my unofficial count, Sierra Johnson's fourth block of the ball game. And they just keep coming. Boy, tremendous athletes for Duncanville. If we don't see them in San Antonio in March, it's because of injuries.
Because I agree.
This team is really good. They just pressure you. And North Shore, again, they are no slouches. They are a really good basketball team. And Duncanville is just, they're playing like they are just at another level. But it is November. And I know that North Shore wants to realize that. It is just November. I think this Mustang team, with Patterson's leadership, they're going to be that much better as the season progresses.
Yes, and you mentioned only being November with teams. You have to worry about peaking too early or not peaking at all, you know, not getting to the right position within the playoffs. And that's something as we almost get pummeled. But that's something, you know, that may or may not be concerning for them to be playing so well this early in the season. I don't know.
Well, it's always important, especially, remember, this team is young still for Duncanville. Sierra Johnson and Madison Talley are seniors, but you got rest of juniors and sophomores. This team's young, and you want to have good habits as the season progresses. You don't want to get into bad habits as the season moves along. And that can happen when you're not winning. Patterson to inbound. Chastity, 17 points now. Chastity Patterson. Once again, Johnson passing out of a double team in the post. The beneficiary, Madison Townley. Townley with 8 points. And another turnover. North Shore will retain possession after the ball was turned over. There we see the old faces. Oh, look at there. Ryan Bright, number 33 of Deer Park. And we saw Nathan Walkup, number 45. Get another shot of Nathan. Nathan playing pro ball, and he was He was something else in his Deer Park days. Shot turnarounder, and it is up and in by Okunie. There we see Nathan.
They look pretty young to me. I don't see any 70 or 80 year olds out there.
Shot is no good, and it is up, and that'll be a Chelsea Green, who is into the game for the first time. Oh boy, I have so many stories on those old guys. And the foul. No good. Or actually, it is good. I beg your pardon, with Green. Chelsea Green, the freshman. Remember when Allison, when we talked about scouting reports and we talked about Green and Hubbard, she said, oh, they probably won't play.
I do remember that, and look, they're on the floor.
They're on the floor, and I'm glad that we got their names, as it's two of the foul. Oh, boy. The basket is good for Star Jacobs. The pass from Alvarez to Jacobs. And she can't get the and one. Patterson getting the rebound and pushing it up the floor. Halfway through the fourth. Ahead the pass, and Green can't get it to go, but that's put up and in by Nina Alvarez. 67-38. My goodness. 29-point lead. Checking out of the ball game is Armani Watson. North Shore looking to inbound. What a touch on after the ball is knocked out of bounds, and it's North Shore basketball. Madison, want to touch on some of the things that this tournament does for the local community, the Education Foundation, the beneficiary of all the profits that are generated from this tournament, from Pasadena ISD and Deer Park ISD. They raise money for the scholarships, and they've done close to $2 million in the time since Mr. Ben Metter has had the tournament, been the tournament director. The sponsorships, the local communities, the hotels, everybody gets involved.
You know, it's so cool to see communities come together for a common cause, for the betterment of humanity. And, you know, for basketball to be a part of that, not only are you watching a fantastic sport, but to know that everything that means basketball right now is going to a better, you know, something more and better, it's just amazing.
400 volunteers as we see Duncanville's horses step out of the ball game, Davis and Green and Johnson. I mean, boy, they're good. Alvarez gets it taken away. Madison Francis with the layup. Francis with her first 2 points of the ballgame. Over 400 volunteers for this tournament, and they range anywhere from selling tickets, being hosts of the teams, working the hospitality room. The hospitality rooms here are outstanding.
Spectacular.
The food that is donated here, donating food and beverage, the community, the businesses that donate the food, and then the people that all organize it and put it together. finding sponsorships. That's a big part of this. McDonald's, they have been the title sponsor since 2003.
And we appreciate the final product, and I don't think people know the time and effort, you know, months in advance that goes into something like this.
They start planning it in January, and they go all the way through. They have an initial meeting, they have a wrap-up meeting in December, and then January, everything comes together.
It's definitely appreciated. I know there's a lot of fans in the stands that are enjoying these games.
Duncanville. All is needed is the final score, as it will be apparent that Duncanville will win the championship for the third time in the last 4 years. Rather, the fourth time in the last 5 years. Underneath, and two more.
You know what I think is so cool about this Duncanville team? They're such a cohesive unit, and they support each other. Like, there have been two plays now, you know, players that haven't had significant time on the floor, but it takes the bench to their feet from excitement of their teammates. I just think that's really cool.
The and one for Tierra Franklin, the junior. So Townley going to University of North Texas. The three-pointer is no good by Nisha Davis. Of course, we have talked about at length of Sierra Johnson going to Louisville, and also Rosie Davis going to Xavier. So it's just so much talent. And also the Duncanville ball club young ladies, they're not only good on the court, they're also good in the classroom too.
Yeah, we talked to, you know, 10, I believe 10 out of 12 of the players from Duncanville are A and B students. Five are a part of the National Honor Society. It's just very impressive that not only they can be successful on the court, but they also can be successful in the classroom.
Jayla Johnson picks up the personal foul. Okuni to the line. One more for Okuni. No good. It's rebounded, though, by North Shore. So back to the free throw line they go with two shots. Kathy Self-Morgan trying to go for another state championship. And she's been at Duncanville since 2000. She also won a state championship at Austin-Westlake. In fact, three of them at Austin-Westlake. And she succeeded the longtime head coach over at Duncanville. This one out of two for North Shore. Sandra Meadows, and they have a tournament that's named after her that they put on every year in December up at Duncanville. Just a long history of rich tradition in basketball.
And it looks like here Duncanville is on some sort of a stall to complete this game.
Yeah, they don't want to take another shot. Classy individuals. I can't say enough over the years of working with Coach Self-Morgan at how appreciative she is of our coverage, and just a classy individual. And she has always given us what we've needed from the media standpoint. I mean, you saw how we interacted.
My first experience today, I mean, your relationships with both of these coaches is unbelievable.
Basket goes inside. Star Jacobs. And so that should do it. North Shore might get a final shot up here with 10 seconds remaining. Patterson going to the basket, and she does. And that'll do it. Duncanville wins. Final score 75-49. And we will step aside and come back with Kathy Self-Morgan, the victorious head coach of the Duncanville Pantherettes, the 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational Gold Division Bracket Champion.
Your job or been denied medical care? Has your doctor told you their panel is full and they cannot take you? At Pasadena Health Center, we make healthcare affordable and provide access to reliable, quality healthcare in a caring atmosphere. We offer services in family medicine, dental, OBGYN, pediatrics, x-ray, lab, and pharmacy. We accept Medicare, Medicaid, private insurance, and offer discounted fees for self-pay patients. Pasadena Health Center, where caring is what we do best.
...2015 Texas Invitational, brought to you by Pasadena Chamber of Commerce, home of the Texas Invitational, City of Pasadena, by Community Bank of Texas, Bank Where You Live, and McDonald's. I'm loving it. Champions of the 2015 Gold Bracket, is we also have sponsors LaPorte Mitsubishi, Refined Auto Designs, refinedautodesigns.biz, and also passing a health center, caring is what we do best. The Division I Gold Bracket champions are the Duncanville Pantherettes, winners 70-49, as they win their fourth championship in 5 years here at this tournament. And just a total domination by Kathy Self Morgan and her Pantherettes as they jumped out quickly to a 17-2 lead. They never looked back as they win here by a final score of 75-49 over Allison Campbell's North Shore Mustangs. And Allison Campbell's North Shore Mustangs last year won this championship game. They defeated Cy Woods, who eventually went on to play and win the state championship in San Antonio at the Alamo Dome. Waiting for Kathy Self Morgan, we're going to take another quick break and come back with our interview with the Victorias head coach right after this. Final, Duncanville 75, North Shore 49.
We deserve a dealership that works hard for us.
You know it.
We deserve low prices and to be told done deal.
At LaPorte Mitsubishi, you know it. We get your deals done with our exclusive guest financing program and the lowest prices like
Outlanders just $209. Outlander Sports as low as $179. Get two Mirages for just $299 a month.
Come to LaPorte Mitsubishi and ask for our exclusive guest financing program.
Get your deal done. You know it.
The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization working with the community to provide the resources educators and students need to achieve educational excellence. The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation, bringing dreams to life for educators and students.
We welcome you to North Shore Marine. We support a large parts and accessories for Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. And we also have parts for your boat, not only just the motor. So you can come in and get pretty much everything you need and be on your way. So you name it, we got it. We sell Sea Arc aluminum boats. A wide variety we try to keep in stock so we can accommodate just about anybody. We service Johnson, Evinrude, Yamaha, and Suzuki. We have a master technician in our staff, and he's highly accredited. Well, of course, we're a family-oriented business. We try to keep it on that level. We're concerned for the well-being of our customers. Come visit us at North Shore Marine.
Duncanville victorious 75-49 over North Shore as North Shore suffers their first loss of the year. They are now 10-1. Duncanville is a perfect 12-0 on the season as they roll here by a victory of 26 points. Momentarily, we're about to be joined by with head coach Kathy Self Morgan of Duncanville. So we see the Pasadena Independent School District Hall of Fame as everybody is recognized and honored. Many, many years of tradition here at Pasadena with all of the sports, football, basketball, softball, baseball. And there is, with all five schools, there is a lot of history and tradition with the Pasadena Independent School District. Join now with the coach of the Duncanville Pantherettes, Kathy Self Morgan. Congratulations, coach.
Thank you very much.
A wonderful victory.
Yes, it was. The kids played hard. We've been working on conditioning since last year when we lost and we shouldn't have. And it's been a long conditioning season. And so this paid off for us to be ready to go five games in 3 days.
I mentioned that that you had won now four out of the last five in this division. And then last year you won the silver division.
That's right. And they've still invited us back. We love coming down here. The hospitality is great. They treat you right. All the games are well organized, and it's just a great tournament.
And also, I was just so impressed with the young ladies, how they just sprinted up and down the court, and they just got out and just really, you pushed it at North Shore.
That's right. We've got a lot of depth, and we've got a lot of payback for last year. That we're just trying to take care of business one at a time and do it as a team.
And also very impressed with how focused they are. They're very focused, and I just see the way they go about just taking care of business.
That's that Pantherette culture.
Yes.
They've got to work, and they've got to have focus.
Looking forward ahead now, I know you're going to play in some other tournaments. You always play in the Classic up there, the Santa Meadows Classic, but district play is going to start, and talk about that a little.
We have a real tough district. We've got Cedar Hill, with Joyner Homes, who has signed with Texas. We've got South Grand Prairie, who's coming on really strong and doing some good things here in the preseason. And, of course, DeSoto is our sister school right down the street. Our cousins play at that school, and it's just a bloodbath. So it's going to be a tough district play.
Congratulations on the win here today, and I'd like to see you again in San Antonio.
Yes, sir. It's where we want to be.
All right.
Thank you.
Kathy Self Morgan of Duncanville as they win by a score of 75-49. We'll come back and wrap it up right after this. 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational on the Time Warner Cable Sports Channel.
Have you recently lost your job or been denied medical care? Has your doctor told you their panel is full and they cannot take you? At Pasadena Health Center, we make healthcare affordable and provide access to reliable, quality healthcare in a caring atmosphere. We offer services in family medicine, dental, OBGYN, pediatrics, x-ray, lab, and pharmacy. We accept Medicare, Medicaid, private insurance, and offer discounted fees for self-pay patients. Pasadena Health Center, where caring is what we do best.
The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation is a nonprofit organization working with the community to provide the resources educators and students need to achieve educational excellence. The Pasadena ISD Education Foundation, bringing dreams to life for educators and students.
Wrapping it up from Phillips Fieldhouse in Pasadena, 2015 McDonald's Texas Invitational. As the Pantherettes victorious over the North Shore Mustangs. One final time back here at Phillips Fieldhouse. I'm Gerald Sanchez along with Madison Wagner. And boy, they're a good ball club, aren't they?
Duncanville definitely has a great road ahead of them. And I think North Shore, losing this game and having a season in front of them, they're going to take this, learn from it. And it's going to be interesting to see them towards the end of the season of how they've progressed and learned from this game.
Final here again as Duncanville wins. And coming up next is the alumni game between Deer Park ISD and Pasadena ISD. And then the big boys showdown, which will be later tonight on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. For Madison Wagner, I'm Gerald Sanchez, wishing you a very pleasant good day from Phillips Fieldhouse in Pasadena. Duncanville, 75, North Shore, 49.